I said earlier that it's a potpourri of fortunes and misfortunes. For the first time, we have judges arrested, we have judges detained, and now we are having judges prosecuted, including a justice of the Supreme Court, the Apex Court. Let me repeat myself for those who have criticized and could keep on criticizing my position. A judge has no reason to be corrupt. A judge has no reason to accept bribe or even to make himself available for bribing. No lawyer who is trained in the best traditions of the bar should encourage, you aid or abet the bribing or the corrupting or the corruption of the judges or of the judiciary. I, Wole Olanipekun, will never do it. Law is so entertaining. Law is so interesting. Law is so beautiful. You can mesmerize with your advocacy. You read your law, present your case. Let the judges do their work. Why bribing them? But having said that, majority of Nigerian judges are good. What we are defending is the institution, not the personal or individual judges. So don't let us throw away the baby with the bathwater. That has been my position.
What do you think about the fact that we have an acting Chief Justice of Nigeria? Many people believe that it's time for the President to send his name to the National Assembly for confirmation.
It's unprecedented where you have an acting Chief Justice of Nigeria. I'm not saying this is the first time we had it. We had it during the time of Muzaffar, but he acted for a few days. And as at that time, his name had been sent to the Senate. The Senate had not cleared him. But now we have a situation in our hands, dicey, kamsi-kamsa, undefinable, fluid, and we are guided, we should be guided. We are bound, and we should be bound by the provisions of the Constitution. It's the ground norm, it's that catechism, it's the catechism of everything we do. Section 231 of the Constitution says, and let me read, appointment of a person to the office of Chief Justice of Nigeria shall be made by the President on the recommendation of the National Judicial Council, subject to confirmation of such appointment by the Senate. It's a triangular something, like a trinity. The NJC will meet, NJC will recommend to Mr. President, to the best of my knowledge, I've served on NJC for 4 years. Two names will always be sent, two or three. The President will pick one. Then send that name, forward that name to the Senate. The Senate will consider, they will interview, they will hold a session, whether public or whatever. Then they will either name, they will either approve or reject. But I'm not aware of any situation in the past where the Senate, or occasion, where the Senate has rejected the nominee for the position of Chief Justice of Nigeria. But we have entire thing hanging. It's just like a bird that perches on a thread. It's so uneasy for the bird, it's so uneasy for the thread. That's the reason we are in now. The NJC has forwarded the name of the Honorable Justice Walter Onogen to the President. President has not forwarded that name to the Senate. Rather, the President has now acted. He has the power to appoint an acting Chief Judge or Chief Justice of Nigeria, just like any governor has the power to appoint. But to my mind, there has been sufficiency of time within which, or from the time the NJC recommended Justice Onogen to Mr. President, and the time the last Chief Justice, the last holder of the office, retired, for the name to be sent or to have been forwarded to the Senate. But we have a situation whereby under Section 231, subsection 5, if a president appoints an acting CJN, that appointment can only last, be sustained, be defended, for 3 months. My fear as a senior advocate of Nigeria, and let me say, without being immodest, as a senior citizen of this country, the position of Chief Justice of Nigeria should not be likened to that of musical chair. It should not. I want to caution, I want to plead that if the president has any reason why the nominee should not be. But my fear, again, not just fear, the position of the law is that I have my very serious doubt. If the president can do without forwarding that name of the person so recommended under section 231(1) to the Senate, I might be wrong, but this is my own position, that does the president has his choice, and we are not having any robust argument on it. Ceasing of silence. This is what the law says. This is the Constitution.
When you say that we're not having any robust argument on this issue, is that not an indictment of lawyers? Shouldn't they be the ones having this argument?
I'm not indicting anybody, but I say there is a ceasing of silence, and the silence is harmful. The silence is not helping the situation.
So what would you say is the way forward?
The way forward, my plea, and I'm now pleading, is that Mr. President should forward that name to the Senate. Let the Senate decide. Afterwards, just last week, Senate decided not to confirm the nomination sent by Mr. President to read in respect of the office of Executive Chairman of EFCC. And to me, the position of Chief Justice of Nigeria is more important, is more paramount, is more fundamental than that of. Then there was something on the internet, I wouldn't know whether or not it's true, nobody has confirmed it, credited to the chief press officer, told Mr. President that the acting Chief Justice of Nigeria is on probation. To me, the Constitution does not accommodate that. The Constitution does not contemplate it. The Constitution does not harbor it. The Constitution is so clear. It is not like Shakespeare's Hamlet, to be or not to be. It's a question of Constitution has given us directives. And the Supreme Court itself has said it over and over that when the law is clear, you apply it.